love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. Bryan, will you have Kathy to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, respond, I will. I will. Kathy, will you have Bryan to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Please be seated. There's one ritual that has to precede now every wedding. It's become a common ritual all over the world. I encourage you to join me in it. Please take out your cell phones and turn them off. Thank you. Also, it'll really help our photographers if you don't take pictures during the ceremony. Thank you. They'll be able to do a much better job if we keep our cameras and phones in our pockets. Thank you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Now's the time.
You guys need a break.
center. There we go. And face me. Thank you. Bryan, will you have Kathy to be your wife? To live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? If so, respond, I will.
I will.
Kathy, will you have Bryan to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? If so, respond, I will.
I will.
Let us pray. Gracious God, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, into the world to reveal your love to all people. Enrich Kathy and Bryan with every good gift, that their life together may show forth your love. And grant that at the last, we may all celebrate with Christ the marriage feast that has no end. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Josh, your reading, please.
Now a quote on love from Bob Marley. Only once in your life, I truly believe, you find someone who can completely turn your world around. You tell them things that you never shared with another soul, and they absorb everything you say and actually want to hear more. You share hopes for the future, dreams that would never come true, goals that were never achieved, and the many disappointments life has thrown at you. When something wonderful happens, you can't wait to tell them about it, knowing that they will share in your excitement. They are not embarrassed to cry with you when you are hurting, or laugh with you when you make a fool of yourself. Never do they hurt your feelings or make you feel like you're not good enough, but rather they build you up and show you things about yourself that make you special and even beautiful. There is never any pressure, jealousy, or competition, but only quiet calmness when they are around. You can only be yourself and not worry about what they will think of you, because they love you for who you are. The things that seem insignificant to most people, such as a note, song, or walk, become invaluable treasures kept safe in your heart to cherish forever. Memories of your childhood come back and are so clear and vivid, it's like being young again. Colors seem brighter and more brilliant. Laughter seems part of daily life, where before it was infrequent or didn't exist at all. A phone call or two during the day helps you to get through a long day's work and always brings a smile to your face. In their presence, there is no need for continuous conversation, but you find you're quite content in just having them nearby. Things that never interest you before become fascinating because you know they are important to this person who is special to you. You think of this person on every occasion, everything you do. Simple things bring them to mind, like a pale blue sky, a gentle wind, or even a cloud on the horizon. You open your heart knowing that there's a chance it may be broken one day, and in opening your heart, you experience love and joy that you never dreamed possible. You find that being vulnerable is the only way to allow your heart to feel treasure, pleasure that's so real it scares you. You find strength in knowing that you have a true friend and possibly a soulmate who will remain loyal to the end. Life seems completely different, exciting, and worthwhile. Your only hope and security is that knowing that they are a part of your life.
Thank you, Josh. A reading from 1 John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. You all have set the bar really high in terms of the kind of love that you want to have for each other. And I just have one thing to share with you, a guarantee, a Pastor Dave guarantee. And that is that if you sink your roots as individuals deep into your relationship with God, then you will have the source of love that will give you the kind of love you want to have for each other until the day you die. And I know long after I'm gone, my hope is this, that I'll be looking down from heaven, seeing you sitting on the porch somewhere as old man and woman holding hands and people walking by saying, how do they do that? How are they still so in love with each other? And if they do happen to stop and ask, you'll be able to say, it's because the source of love, God, is where we draw our love from, for each other and for the world. I think you're ready to be married. You'll have to hand your flowers to Brianna. Well, we're going to have a hymn of the day.
First. Hymn of the day first, Brian.
Yeah, but that's okay.
Okay. She can't hold them now. She can put up.
It looks good. Bryan, please repeat after me. In the presence of God and this community.
In the presence of God and this community.
I, Bryan, take you, Kathy, to be my wife.
I, Bryan, take you, Kathy, to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Kathy, please repeat after me. In the presence of God and this community.
In the presence of God and this community.
I, Kathy, take you, Bryan, to be my husband.
I, Kathy, take you, Bryan, to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
The wedding ring has been a symbol of marriage since marriage has been around almost. The eternal nature of the relationship being symbolized by the circle and the precious metal symbolizing the preciousness of it. You may exchange rings at this time.
Sorry.
Kathy, please repeat after me. Bryan, I give you this ring.
Bryan, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
Bryan, please repeat after me. Kathy, I give you this ring.
Kathy, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love and faithfulness.
As a sign of our love and faithfulness.
Now it's time for the tree ceremony.
Thank you.
Bryan and Kathy, by their promises before God and in the presence of this assembly, have joined themselves to one another as husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one separate. Amen. Thanks be to God. The Lord God, who created our first parents and established them in marriage, establish and sustain you, that you may find delight in each other and grow in holy love until your life's end. Amen.
Now it's
going to turn.
Go ahead.
Thank you. Wouldn't want to miss that.
That was actually a little bit of relief thinking. Today I feel excitement, hope, love, and joy. I have to keep pinching myself to really believe this is happening. 20 years ago, my life changed in ways I could never have imagined, and I found myself alone with two young children. I was devastated by a loss so profound, but needed to pick up and move forward because that's what parents do. I survived only by focusing on the two most important people in my life, James and Josh. My life became all about them, and for many years it was full and I believed I was happy. I wouldn't change a thing about those years. Those experiences shaped me into the person standing before you today. As kids do, the boys grew up, and their lives became less about me and all about becoming the young men they were destined to be. And that's okay, because that's how things are meant to be. Suddenly, though, I was alone. So I got another dog, and I called him Harley. Harley was my loyal companion through the many lonely days and nights in an empty nest, and I felt certain that that's how my life would be. When I first met you, I honestly didn't know you were going to be this important to me. It wasn't love at first sight or anything close to that. You were somewhat of a mystery, I lost my place, and I really didn't give you much thought. And then everything changed with an unlikely email. Over the course of many weeks, we began to see each other in a different light. On our first date at Tuscany Grill, sitting across from you like a young schoolgirl with the first crush, I realized just then just how much I'd been missing, and I knew my life would never be the same. I think it took you a little bit longer to figure that out. We were both so scared of letting someone new in, but together we found the courage to open ourselves up to love again. I learned through the growth of this relationship that you were nothing like I had imagined. At our core, we are very much alike, yet in many respects, we are so different. Sorry. The beauty is we understand and respect those differences, and in doing so, bring out the very best in each other. We are so much better together than we could ever be on our own. With you, I see the world differently. With you, I am the very best version of myself. With you, I see no limit to what I can accomplish. With you, I see my puzzle complete. 29 really long months to the day later after that first night at Tuscany, at the very same table and in the most romantic fashion, you proposed. Finally, is what everyone else said. And here we are 11 months and one day later, and I just have to pause for a moment and take in the beauty of it all. I never, ever imagined myself here again, ever. I'm so incredibly blessed to be surrounded today by the people that mean the world to me. Our parents, our families, our kids, friends from near and far, and you. But more than that, I am blessed that God knew I had room in my heart for more love, and he gave me the courage to let you in. You are my partner, my love, my future, and in the midst of this very ordinary journey we were on, you are my fairy tale. The answer to a dream I had not allowed myself to have for many years because it was just too painful. You made me realize that it's never too late for happily ever after. And I promise with every ounce of who I am to love you with my whole heart for my whole life. All right. No. Let's see what you got.
Mine's only one page.
But it's smaller font, so.
She double-spaced too.
Kathy, I'll never forget that first text. It was a simple question, but from someone I barely knew. It asked how I was doing. The subsequent one was an offer to talk if I needed someone. At the time, it seemed strange. Really, the first time someone had asked me the question at a time that maybe really I did need someone to ask. What I soon learned about you is one of the things I love about you so much now, that is in your nature to care about others with all your heart. It doesn't matter if it is family, friends, or a stranger, you think about others. But what I love most now is how this beautiful quality of yours has had an impact on me, on how I look at other people, interact with them, interact with my family, friends, and coworkers. You bring out the best in me, and you make me feel wanted. The last 3 years with you have been incredible. I've grown closer to you than anyone ever before. We've already had some great adventures, and I can't wait for a lifetime more of them. I look forward to continuing our careers with each other. I love the fact one or both of us can be stressed with work and can help each other through it. But mostly I love that we know when to turn work off and be us. I look forward to our families getting to know each other better, but particularly our children. We have 5 incredible adult children. I am in awe of all you've done to raise your kids as a single mother, and not just your own children, but the many others who saw you as sort of a second mom, some of who are celebrating with us today. I love the way you've welcomed my children into your life as a trusted friend, and I thank my kids for welcoming you into their lives. I look forward to learning from you and sharing with you the great times that are ahead for our family. Most people here know that you have the gift of using words, and to prove that opposites attract, I don't. So I struggle with how to end this, and I finally decide just to steal some words from our song. Kathy, I want to hold your hand forever.
Oh, amen. 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 I'd like to invite those of you...
Oh, shit. I win.
I'm good. I'm good. I invite those of you who are comfortable doing so to please join me as we pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God is the one who blesses us, and I think God laughs and cries with us. God sends us into the world to bring God's light and love with us into the world. Bryson, you're going to go to your guitar, please. May God Almighty send you light and truth to keep you all the days of your life. The hand of God protect you. The holy angels accompany you. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Would you please face the folks? Would you join me in congratulating Bryan and Kathy? Woo!
Oh, thank you.
'Cause everything that don't make sense about me makes sense when I'm with you. Like everything that's green, girl, I need you. But it's more than one and one makes two. I put aside the math and the logic of it. You gotta know you want it too. 'Cause I wanna wrap you up, wanna kiss your lips. I wanna
she's done for us if he wasn't standing by my side. So I'm just gonna do a brief rundown. I actually wrote this entire speech, wrote it out, which is not like me at all. I try so hard to be like my mom. My mom is very meticulous. She gets everything planned out. One of my best friends, Keith Claybell, actually got here at 4:31. He's like, it's gonna be cool. I can show up a little late. He should have thought about my mom. She doesn't do anything. She doesn't do anything late. The ceremony started at 4:30. Keith got here at 4:30 and a half. I wanted to do this speech. I wanted to talk about how much Josh and my mother meant to me. I wanted to talk about what they've done for me. I wanted to talk about so many things. I wanted to give you guys a whole lowdown of what she's done for us. But she told me that it had to be a toast and it couldn't be any longer than like 15 minutes. So I was thinking about, you know what I can do? I can do a fun fact for every year of my mom's life. That was not fun. I don't have that many fun facts. We were a great team, I'm not gonna lie. You know, me and Josh, we did anything and everything together, and it was always by the lead of her. No. Which is not normal, because most guys are raised by a lead of, I don't even know how to say it. It's
father figure. So, we had a mother figure.
You've been through more than anyone in this world needs to go through. I wanted to be up here and I wanted to be perfect. I was so nervous. I've been pacing. I haven't sat down yet. I'm serious. I sat down when I came in from the introduction, which, by the way, I thought it was going to be separate. What happened? I appreciate him holding the Anderson on my name. James Anderson? That felt cool. But we all had our own dances, and then it was just the kids with Bryan and Kathy. What? So honestly, I haven't sat down. And it's not because I'm nervous about being in front of you guys. I know everybody here, most of the few guys. If I don't remember you, I'm sorry. It's a long life. I'm 28 years old. I wanted to kill this speech more than anything. I wanted to kill this speech for you because you've done so much for us. I wanted to be perfect. Perfect. I wanted to be perfect. There's no such thing as perfect in this life. My mom's been through more things than anybody in this room would even hope to want to ever be through. It's rough what we've been through. She's always been unselfish. The only people that mattered in my mom's life is standing behind me and holding a microphone. That's it. Nothing mattered about her. She didn't care what anybody thought about her. She just wanted me and Josh to have the best opportunity to have the best life that she could provide for us. And I can't be happier for her to finally stop being unselfish and start being selfish. I mean that the nicest way I can mean it. Everybody's been talking about this speech. James, you're gonna kill this speech. James, we know you're the best talker. Derek, can you stand up for a second? You're the best talker I've ever seen in my life, James. Remember that, Derek. You said that. But I have to brag about her. She's bragged about me for 28 years. She's bragged about him for 22.
First year was rough.
I don't want to directly quote, I want to paraphrase a quote, one of my favorite quotes, from the movie The Count of Monte Cristo. He says to his son, he doesn't even know it's his son yet, he says, life is a storm. One minute, you're basking in the sun, the next you crash upon the rocks. What matters is what you do when that storm comes. How do you face it? You say to that storm, do your worst, because I'll do mine. And you've done yours. You've taken everything bad and turned it around and made it good. We had... When I was born, when I was young, we had no money. I didn't know that. Our favorite pastime was watching Cops and eating popcorn. I thought that was the point. She let me live for 5 years saying I'm under the rest. That's not what they said. You're the most important person in my life because we're a team. You and me and Josh. We've weathered the storm. And then you met Bryan. Someone I never thought you'd meet because you gave up on love. And by the way, she stole my speech. The speech she read at the wedding, that was mine. I wrote it. That was all my words. I read everything. I was like, this is verbatim. But you did. You weathered the storm. You gave up your own love. You gave everything away just so that we would be happy, so that we would have a chance to be something. And then you had Harley. By the way, that was our idea.
Yeah.
That was our idea. She didn't say that in the speech. That was our idea. We left the house. Like she said, we left the nest. And we wanted something to be there to protect her. We adopted Harley's brother and sister. Oh, I'm sorry. We adopted Harley's sisters, Paisley and Gotti. We own them now. We called my mother. You're going to be by yourself. You need someone to protect you. We want you to adopt Harley. She's like, I need to think about it. She called me back 10 minutes later. She thought about it. She got Harley, but then she got Bryan. Harley's got Egyptian eyes. That's about all he's got going for him. Bryan's got everything else. When we were standing up there, me and Josh are pretty tough kids. We've been through struggles, to say the least. But Mom always turned it around to make it something better. Even now, I'm 28 years old, and if something goes wrong, I just call my mom, and she finds the good in the wrong. She's still trying to make us better people, even though we've already gone, we've already left. What is that? Bryan, I have to say first before I say anything else, I love the fact that you love when I make fun of my mom. I love that. I think it's the funniest thing in the world, because he laughs at every joke I talk about my mom. It doesn't matter. He thinks it's the funniest thing in the world. He's like, I can't say that, but I'll let you do it. When I was walking back with Brianna and Josh, I was like, you guys are so lucky. You've already finished. You've already done your jobs. And you killed it. Josh struggled through a part of that speech that we know of. Brianna killed her song. Let's give it up for Brianna, by the way. Can we also give it up for Bryson, by the way, who was killing it on the guitar. And I'm also going to say, can we give it up for Brendan? He's probably the tallest one out of all the kids. I'm not that guy. But I just gotta say thank you. Thank you for weathering that storm. Thank you for weathering the storm being unselfish. Because everything that you did led you to Bryan. Everything that you did led you to Bryan. It led you to happiness. And here you are with everybody that loves you, friends and family, people that just want to see you smile. You look like a fairy princess. I love you, Mom. I love you to death. Here's to Bryan and Kathy.
The week we brought her home, this baby.
hold on. It won't be like this for long. Four years later, about 4:30, she's crawling in their bed. And when he drops her off at preschool, she's clinging to his leg. The teacher peels her off for him. He says, what can I do? She says, now don't you worry, this'll only last a week or two. It won't be like this for long. One day soon you'll drop her off and she won't even know you're gone. This phase is gonna fly by if you can just hold on. It won't be like this for long. Someday soon she'll be a teenager, and at times he'll think she hates him. Then he'll walk her down the aisle and raise her veil. But right now she's up and crying, and the truth is that he don't mind as he kisses her goodnight and she says her prayers.
On your first day of school, so long ago, I held back all the tears I didn't want to show. Some moments live forever. I still see you there in play. Those imagined trips on little rocket ships seem like only yesterday. In a heartbeat, the boy becomes a man. All I did was turn around and let go of your hand, and here you are, everything a man is meant to be. All I ever dreamed of, smiling back at me. There are feelings only mothers ever know, like the secret pride I felt through all the years I've watched you grow. Now we're at this moment, a new chapter has begun. My dreams for you are all coming true, 'cause I know you found. Turn around and let go of your hand, and here you are, everything a man is meant to be. All I ever dreamed of, smiling back at me.
Who spent more time on Facebook? better taste of this. Who is a better dresser? Who is a better driver? We all know this one. Who spends more time in the mirror? Who made the first move? Who said, "I love you" first? Who is always right? More of the groceries shopping. Who will be paying the bills? Who is more organized? And right now, who do you love more than anyone in this world? Give it up for Bryan and Kathy.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When you dance, 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 feel good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. Stop with all those things I shouldn't do. But you dance, dance, dance. Ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing. Yeah.